This is Bethel College Volleyball, live on the Bethel Sports Network.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Andrew Boyer with the Bethel Sports Network here at Tim Saravolo. We are here at Bethel College, welcomes Huntington University into Goodman Gymnasium. Bethel comes in with a Crossroads League record of 4-6 on this season. Foresters come in with 5-5. Now let's talk about the standings real quick. Bethel comes in right now. They're in that all-important eighth spot in the Crossroads League. As we know, the top eight teams get into the tournament at the end of the year. And a win tonight would boost them right up, battling for that fourth spot where Huntington is. While the key players come in, Zoe Wolfenbarger leads the team in kills with 177, followed by Haley Brown and Cassandra Williams with 152 and 143 apiece. And also in digs, Aaron Carlos comes in leading the team with 284. That is 3.7 per set. Kristen Mitchell comes in 219 and bring up the rear Peyton Anderson with 187. Now, this is going to be a very good matchup. See where the teams go up. Starting it out, Vegas is what they call Wolfenbarger. She comes out starting to serve for Pilots.
And the Pilots, you know, they've struggled at home. They're only 1-7 at home this year. They really need this win. This is a game they can win. Huntington, as you said, 5-5, so important game here for the Pilots.
Definitely. Wolfenbarger back to serve. Clean serve over the net. Out. That's first point. First point is pivotal for the Pilots. They got to kind of get over the season, over the course, they've had issues with getting things rolling, getting momentum rolling, but good start there.
Yeah, and Coach Wingard has talked about the team getting off to slow starts and not having that killer instinct. And so that's it. You're right, that's important.
Free point for the Pilots. Kristen Mitchell brings it over. Brought home by number 11, Josie Bevier from Huntington.
And that's Coach Wigand for the Bethel Pilots, by the way. I misspoke.
Yep, Coach Rochelle Wigand.
Wigand.
Set up. Haley Brown brings it home. She is playing tough tonight. You'll see her taped up on the hips there, but she's toughing it out, and she's just bringing it home.
Nice touch on that little dink.
Kristen Mitchell back to serve for the Pilots. Gets it over clean. Out.
Just out.
Just a hair over that line.
Missed it by that much.
All right, Foresters bringing number 15, Haley Longley. And number 6, Brianna Levings back to serve. Clean serve over there, dig by Christian Mitzel.
Oh, nice save.
Katie. Great save there by Aaron Carlos. Number 6, Brianna Levings back to the Foresters. Quick set. And brought home by number six, Amanda Brinkman for the Pilots. Bringing it home with authority there. In comes Cassandra Williams. She leads the team in blocks, folks, so that should help with the defensive side. Haley Brown back to serve.
Ooh, good effort. Looked like that might have gone out.
Nice little quick tip over the net there, Foresters. Number 2, Michaela Carpenter back to serve for the Foresters. Kristen Mitchell sends it over. So you're going to get something up here for Huntington. Over it goes. Dig by Aaron Carlos. Sandra Williams.
Oh, nice shot.
It. And in. Just snuck it in there to tie it up 4-4.
Really well-placed shot.
Well-placed. Good zone there from Cassandra Williams. Now back to serve for the Pilots, Peyton Anderson. Clean serve over let. Set something up. Kristen Mitchell with the dig. And those things that we see from Bethel all the time, those mental mistakes coming in, every game, it seems like they happen. They bounce back, but they happen all too often.
Yeah, those add up.
They do add up. Daniel Gerwell back. Service error into the net. ties it up 5-5. That's a free point for the Pilots. Just take them when we can get them.
Could call that a mental error as well. Those service.
Definitely happens on both sides. Brought home clean by number 18, Callie Collins.
That was a strong kill.
Had a little bit of heat on it.
Nicely placed.
Coming in for Huntington, number 11, Josie Bevier. Number 3, Emily Hubby back to serve for the Foresters. Dig by Aaron Carlo, set up. Kristen Mitchell brings
nice.
It home for the Pilots. Well done there. They are going back and forth. And you see this trend with Bethel as they go through games. They kind of go back and forth in momentum until someone finds their footing. And kind of go on a little bit of a run.
Yeah, Bethel's streaky. If they were more consistent, they'd probably win more.
Callie Collins brings it over. Kristen Mitchell bringing it back. Dig by Kate Cobb.
Double hit there.
Double hit there gives the points to the Pilots. Erin Carlos back to serve. She has the libero jersey on. Callie Collins kicks it over. Nice save. Kristen Mitchell in.
Beautiful.
Beautiful kill. Well placed by Kristen Mitchell.
A really nice save to set that up, too.
Definitely. And now we're see we're kind of getting onto a little bit of a run here. See if they can keep the momentum in their favor. Nice serve over the net. Set it up. Nice front line play set up for Zoe Wolfenbarger, and
nice.
That's a kill. Vegas takes it. Add another one to her kill column.
Really nicely set up. Very well played.
Nicely set up there by Peyton Anderson. Set one up. Good dig there by Anderson. Just couldn't get it back over the net. And it seems like a little bit of miscommunication there on the Pilot side. And they didn't know who was going to get it there, but move on. Audrey Mallers back to serve for the Foresters. Set up nice. Another dig there. Mitchell tips it over. Okay, Cobb sets it up for Taylor Schlund. Cobb sets it up, and brought home by Josie Bevier. Just off the hands of the Bethel front line.
Yeah, they were in place for the block, but it just bounced off the side.
Service error there by number 7, Audrey Mallers. Once again, we'll take all those free points. We forget Bethel wins. Bethel's winning right now, 10-8. Vegas back to serve for the Pilots. And answers right back with the service error. Don't see too many of those from her.
No. Can't afford that.
Can't afford those mental mistakes. Give it right back to the Foresters. Kate Cobb back. Peyton Anderson just has to set it over. Free ball. Nice little tip over. Quick set back by Anderson. And out.
It was a good idea.
Good idea.
There was an opening there, but
execution was just not there for that one.
Just a little too hard.
A little too much mustard on that one. Kate Cobb back to serve again for the Foresters. Kate Cobb brings it back in, sets it up for Bevier. To Anderson. Mitchell brings it home for the Pilots. Well done there by Mitchell. She showed up to play today, did Kristen Mitchell. Now she's back to serve. Four. and over the net. That is a net call on the Foresters. Point goes to Bethel. Bethel has the lead 12-10 now. They're kind of inching away with it.
Mitchell needs another nice serve here.
Would definitely help. Nice serve, got it over, Belvier. Over set up Peyton Anderson. Wolfenbarger brings it home. There's a kill for another one for Zoe.
And Aaron Carlos has been all over the floor digging, making a lot of really nice digs.
He is digging a hole right now. That's a good thing in volleyball terms, folks. Now, going into a timeout. Pilots lead 13-10. They're feeling good right now. They're showing a little bit of confidence. They got a little bit of swagger going. So not a bad conversation like we've seen in past from Coach Rochelle Wiegand. Just keep it going. Keep the mental mistakes to a minimum and get back out there. Would you say so?
Yes, and this is where she talked about sometimes the team doesn't have that killer instinct. They get ahead and they tend to let down a little bit. And this is, I think, she's probably reminding them right now. Okay, we got a lead. Let's stay on it. Let's keep our foot in the gas.
Definitely. Don't take your foot off that pedal or foot off the throat there. You got to keep it going, because if you let them get back into it, they will get back into it. It's shown that they can do that, and it's happened to Bethel over and over again. So just keep your composure, keep that killer instinct, that focus set, and go take this set. Go up 1-0.
Right, and they're only up 3, so it's not like Huntington's out of it.
Yeah, it's not like they've
got the momentum, and they just need to keep it.
Definitely. Going back out, Kristen Mitchell is back there to serve. She's been all over the floor tonight, doing well. Peyton Anderson in.
Oh, nice
ace
serve
for Kristen Mitchell. Definitely needed that to come out of the timeout. Keep the momentum in Bethel's favor. See if they can get on a little bit of a rally.
She's been serving really well. Little touch serve.
Set up. Bevier brings it home for the Foresters. That was Josie Bevier again. Well done. Seemed like a little bit of miscommunication off the serve, but they got their heads back in and brought it home. Bethel's up 14-11. Chipping away at that lead. Number 6, Brianna Leaving's back. Peyton Anderson. Haley Brown brings that one home with some authority. Haley Brown back to serve. Set up nicely. Well done by the Bethel block, just no one there to retrieve it. Michaela Carpenter back to serve. Set up Peyton Anderson. And brought home Cassandra Williams with the tip. She's feeling it. She's always got a smile on her face, folks. Very enthusiastic about that one.
That was a nice play.
Just a nice little tip over
smart.
The net.
Wasn't much else she could do. Smart play.
Peyton Anderson back to serve. Set up. And brought down by number 7, Audrey Mallers on that one. Coach Wiegand throwing her hands up. Got to get the block up there and stop those. Kristen Mitchell set up to Anderson. Block knocks it up. Set up. Anderson sets up. Williams. Wolfenbarger brings it home. Well done, Vegas. Very good point there. Some very good kills there for kill attempts, should I say, for Amanda Brinkman. Her and Vegas are the only seniors on the team, definitely showing that leadership as the game goes on. Katie Easter back to serve.
Lollipop serve.
Ooh, well nice. Done by the block. Looks like that one hit a brick wall. Cassandra Williams and Christian Mitchell all over that one. Pilots are still feeling it up 18-13. Katie Easter still back to serve. Set up, Peyton Anderson setting it up for Wolfenbarger. Katie Cobb. Mahomes. The front line is showing up. Cassandra Williams and Vegas on that one, knocking it back right in their face.
Cassandra Williams perfectly timed that block.
Well done there. Katie Easterback serve. Looks like the Pilots are at a little bit of a rally. Kristen Mitchell bringing it home again. Well done through the first set. Pilots are feeling it. Going into a timeout for Huntington. Fans are into it. Everyone's liking what they're seeing here. Pilots go into the timeout, 20-13.
Yeah, this is some of the best volleyball I've seen this year from them, this stretch. Really good.
Definitely, and they need it after their last win was against Grace College on September 28th. They come back October 1st, get swept by Lourdes University. So they need this win tonight. They've kind of been on the losing end the last, they've won one of the last six games and only won a set in that game that they won. So definitely some great volleyball from them, playing with some confidence. That's what I like to see. And Rochelle, we can give them that pep talk saying, hey, don't let off the gas. You're up seven, you're up. I know you're playing confident, you're happy with what you're doing, but keep that focus. Keep that your eyes on the prize here. Five more points brings this one home, and they're up 1-0, which they have proven.
Exactly.
Can win them games, because when losing the first set, Bethel is 0-11 on the season.
Wow.
So that first set, getting out to that good start, is pivotal for the Pilots.
Plus, as we've talked, they're 1-7 at home, so they really... we really need to get a win at home.
Definitely need to protect this house. Katie Easterback serve. And out. Not what they needed coming out of the timeout.
Not the way to start.
Bethel looks like they need to regroup. Chance for Huntington to get some momentum back as they send number three, Emily Hubby, back to serve. Bring it over. Easter with the dig, Peyton Anderson, Cassandra Williams makes it, blocked. Nice there by Aaron Carlos. Williams would have to send it over. Cut over there, brought home by number 11, Josie Beviere. Hubby back to serve again. Huntington chipping away at this lead. Carlos to come back, Easter to Mitchell, brings it over, set it up. Devier just has to take that one up. Four hits on Huntington, that's a point for Bethel. Four more to take this first set. Haley Brown comes in for the Pilots. Cassandra coming out, she's feeling it after that little run. And Carlos back to serve, she has a libero spot. Set up. Tipped over by Aubrey Mallers.
Back row got in just a little too far. Snuck it by him.
Mallers back to serve. Too much for Carlos to handle. That's an ace for Huntington. They are now only down four.
That seemed like a mental error. That didn't seem like a very difficult play. And Carlos has been playing really well, but she seemed a little bit out of position there.
Carlos with the dig right there, set up to Anderson. Wolfenbarger ends it over. Devere. Carlos sets it up. Zoe, there it is, brings it home. 22-17 now for the Pilots. Vegas is feeling it right now.
They needed that point.
That was one they needed. Now she's back to serve. She's calling down from the point. Set up. Blocked as well. Peyton Anderson sets it over. Quick set. And that's something Peyton Anderson is so good at. Every game you see her come in, she has to make a quick decision. She sees an open zone on the other side, so you just set it right over. She is so good at that.
Nice play. Well placed.
Vegas back to serve again. little quick tip over. Not much you can do there, just not enough pilots. And it's enough. Haley Brown, Kate Cobb with the dig. Aaron Carlos gets it back over from the tip.
Oh,
miscommunication, but Katie Easter is able to bring it back over. Free ball set up. Carlos with another dig. Well done there. Kristen Mitchell just has to set it over. Net violation for the Pilots.
Again, poor communication on that and mental errors.
Seems to be the story. Kate Cobb back to serve. Received well. Peyton Anderson sets up. Kristen Mitchell off the block. Anderson, is that a net? Well, that is a point for Huntington.
Coach Wiegand might consider a timeout here.
Seems like she's challenging that last call there. There's a timeout by Coach Wiegand. They're doing exactly what she said not to do. It's about they're letting the foot off the gas, and they're 2 points away from taking this set. We see this over and over again from the Pilots, and at some point you just got to say, hey, just got to bring it home, calm down, keep the focus.
Yeah, I think this is a really smart timeout. Just let everyone collect themselves and regroup. Like you said, just a couple points here.
A couple points is all it takes, and they're definitely kind of calm down, get the playing great, but you're not there yet. You don't have the right to celebrate just yet. You haven't won yet. You haven't won anything. Not a set yet.
Well, they were up 6 or 7 points, and then they just got a little bit sloppy. Had some poor communication, some mental errors.
A little
and then lo and behold, they're only up 3.
Pilots definitely need to keep the pressure on. Kate Cobb back to serve for Huntington, brings it right over. Wolfenbarger gets it up. Peyton Anderson, Kristen Mitchell tries to bring it home to block. Well done there by Aaron Carlos. Set up. Bevier again. Josie Bevier having a great game so far for the Foresters. Sends it back. Kate Cobb back to serve again. Aaron Carlos, Peyton Anderson up. Haley Brown to bring it home.
A clutch kill. Really needed that.
Haley Brown brings it home. It is now set point, 24-21 for the Pilots. Kristen Mitchell back to serve. This is the one that they need, folks. Set up. Oh, it sets up. Got to bring it back over. Free ball for the Foresters. Good job by the block. Set up again. Out! That's the set. Pilots take first set, 25-21. That's the one they needed, folks. They're going to switch sides now.
Yeah, those last 2 points were really well played. The timeout was perfect. They got their act together. Played those 2 last points exceptionally.
Definitely the momentum's in their favor now. They're kind of calmed down. They can say, hey, we won the first set. And after winning the first set, the Pilots are 8-3 on the season. Much better than their losing percentage, 0-11 when losing the first set. So now you can say, kind of, hey, we see some good things in that first set. We did great things. We made it. So let's not take our foot off the gas. We've also done some wrong things. Let's correct the mistakes, go into the second set, and get a win.
Right. Got some really timely plays. Haley Brown with that kill at 23-21. That really brought the momentum back. Aaron Carlos has just been all over the court with some great defensive play. I know that's what she's going for, but she's really doing it tonight.
Definitely. Coming into this game, 284 digs for Carlos. Add to that number tonight, she is doing very well. Also, Uh, also with a couple of points there. Peyton Anderson, she's the setter, brings it up, gets that quick set over the net. And we touched on it a little bit, but the decision-making ability you have to have from that. The first hit in a volleyball game flows down on the basics. The second hit is always supposed to go to the setter, and that's Peyton Anderson. It's a very important job. But it's her decision. She needs to set up a spike, set up a hit, or she can do a little quick set if she sees an open zone on the court. You quick set it over, get into the open zone, try to get a quick point. And she has been so good time and time again on those quick decisions to just get it right over and kind of get a quick shot.
Yeah, she's made good decisions, and she's had great placement. You know, she's put it in the right spot where Huntington can't quite get to it.
Here we have the stats for that first set. Huntington, Josie Bevier leads the team in kills for Huntington. 6 kills in that first set. Well, first set was owned by Zoe Wolfenbarger and Kristen Mitchell for Bethel, each with 4. Haley Brown coming up again with 3. 2 for Cassandra Williams, and Peyton Anderson with 1 kill. Amanda Brinkman also with 1 kill.
Aaron Carlos with 7 digs.
7 digs in the first, 20 digs total as a team. 4 digs for Peyton Anderson and Katie Easter, and then 1 apiece for Haley Brown and Zoe Wolfenbarger. Very well played first set by Bethel. Bethel takes it 25-21.
Yeah, if I had to choose an MVP of the first set, I would say it was Aaron Carlos. I mean, the whole team played well, but her defensive play really kept a lot of plays alive. She was all over the court.
Definitely looked to carry that momentum into the second half, into the second set, rather. So now Bethel coming in. They got a little bit of fire in their eyes, a little bit of, they're loosening up, showing a little bit of confidence. Mm-hmm. But as you can see, confidence rears its head, and you get a little complacent. They got a battle complacency is kind of been the motto for Bethel's season so far. Battle complacency and overcome adversity. So definitely good to see Pilots take the first set. Now let's see if they can go into it 2-0, starting it out. Another did by Carlos, set up to Peyton Anderson. Zoe brings it home, but the block is there. Josie Bevier and Mason Tyree there for the Foresters. Well done. It was like that ball at a brick wall. Peyton Anderson there. Kristen Mitchell. Bevier there again. Quick tip over. That's a net violation from the Pilots.
That was close. I didn't see it.
Emily Hubby back serve for Foresters. Peyton Anderson set up. Wolfenbarger does quick tip over. Block is there. Mitchell sends it over. Free ball set up. Quick shot. Anderson.
Carlos
set
again
up
with a great save.
Mitchell tip right over. A free ball for the Pilots. Peyton Anderson set up. Kristen Mitchell. Sends it over, Hubby to Bevier. The block is there. Miscommunication between Vegas and Williams. They don't know who's supposed to get it. Pilots go into the second set to the 3-0 start. Foresters have all the momentum on their side right now. Ball goes over the net. Williams, miscommunication, service error, whatever you want to call it, folks. Mental mistake, timeout. Coach Rochelle Wiegand does not look happy going into this timeout. Down 4-0 to start the second set. This was not the start the Pilots wanted to see.
Yep, it's that classic case of what Coach Wiegand has been telling us. They get up and they relax and got up a set. We're playing really well. Got off to a slow start here. Don't want to dig a deep hole.
It's that battle of complacency. Moment in the timeout, team talking to each other. Rochelle Wiegand trying to figure out what to say. And at this point, you look at your senior leaders. Your seniors, Zoe Wolfenbarger and Amanda Brinkman, those are your leaders. Those are your seniors. Those are the ones you have to bring in. Those are the ones you come into for in this kind of situation. When you're down, when you don't know what to do, the younger guys don't, younger girls rather, don't know what to do in this situation. You look to that senior leadership to say, hey, get it together. We can do this. It's not as big as you think.
And they have to be vocal, but they also have to show it on the court. And I think they will.
I'll be back to serve. Carlos the dig. Peyton Anderson goes. Christian Mitchell. And the block is there again. But it goes out. That's a point for the Pilots. Chipping away at this deficit. Now down 4-1. Aaron Carlos back to serve for the Pilots. Cobb with the dig. Brings it up. And that's out, folks. That is a point for the Pilots. 4-2 now.
Once again, a well-placed timeout. Coach Wiegand calling the timeout and changing the momentum.
Bevere. Mistake there from Bevere. I haven't seen too many of those from Erdnight. Carlos to serve, gets it over. Cobb with the dig, set up by Hubby. Mallers takes it over. Huntington now up 5-3. With Audrey Mallers back to serve. Service error into the net. Beth will take those points where they can get them. 5-4 now, looking like a much different set. After the timeout, Vegas back to serve. And a little too much juice on that one from Vegas. Definitely not what the Pilots needed to see. Finally getting momentum shifted back in their favor. Kate Cobb back to serve.
Oh, missed opportunity there.
Set up, off the block, Peyton Anderson, quick set over the net. Cobb with a wonderful dig, takes it over, another free ball. Peyton Anderson, Kristen Mitchell, tip over the net. Hubby. And nice dig by Katie Easter, tip right over by Peyton Anderson. Cobb sets up, Bevere takes it up and brings it home for Huntington.
I thought Bethel missed a couple opportunities there to really set it up for a nice spike, and they just didn't have the patience.
Not quite doing it there for the Pilots to be able to brought home by Bevere again. They caught back to serve. Easter big Anderson. Mitchell bring home off the block tip. Hubby sets it up, and Bevere off a brick wall block there. Well done for the Pilots defense, Mitchell and Brown there. Bring it home. Score is now 5-7.
Yeah, Brown was really on that block.
Amanda Brinkman comes in now for the Pilots to help out that front line as well. Kristen Mitchell back to serve. Cut up, Hubby. And brought home there by Danielle Gerwell. Bevere comes out for Huntington. She's had a magnificent game for Huntington so far. Set up. Peyton Anderson sets up. Kristen Mitchell be able to bring it over. Free ball for the Pilots. Very lucky there. Haley Brown brings it over. Dug by number 6. Kate Cobb sets over and over by Mallers. Peyton Anderson just quick tip over. Gerwell, Cobb. Anderson sets up, Brown, too much on it there for Haley Brown. That's a point for Huntington. Those little mistakes we keep talking about are coming back to haunt the Pilots here. Now down 9-5. Brianna Levings back to serve for Huntington now. Serve coming over, Peyton Anderson sets up. Block off a brick wall, but. And a service error there from Wolfenbarger. Don't see too many of those from her these days. Couldn't afford to have that right there. Five, down 10-5 now. Anderson sets up, Brown back to the back, and out.
That looked like a well-placed shot, just out.
Yes, barely. I thought it touched the line, but did not. Service error from Huntington. Maybe that's what the Pilots needed. That's the spark to get them back in. Haley Brown back to serve now. And in comes Cassandra Williams to help out the block game. We got Amanda Brinkman and Cassandra Williams in the block. Set up. There's a point for Bethel. 11-7 now the deficit. Haley Brown back to serve, and she is playing hurt, folks. Kate Cobb with the dig set up there. And brought home by Haley Longley.
The lefty. Strong kill by the lefty.
Taylor Schultius comes out for Huntington. Back to serve is Mallard. Anderson sets up, Brinkman, and out again. They're making nice plays, the Pilots are. They're just putting too much on it, and they're carrying themselves in the long run with that. Now down 6 points.
Yeah, I thought that was a good shot, just a little long.
And you see that over and over again in this game. This is definitely a trend in the second set. They're picking their spots well. They're just not executing the way that they should be.
Yeah, that looked like the right shot because the back row of Huntington was pulled in a little bit. She got it over their head, but just a little too long.
Coach Regan coming into the huddle now telling our girls, you got to be fundamentally sound. Get it in there. Get your serves over the net. Every little thing just to help the team out, because the little mental errors, the little fundamental mistakes can really be the difference maker in the long run. They're down 6. They're not out yet. And they've shown some good things in this game so far. They've shown good defense. They've shown well-placed quick sets over the net. It's not like they're not playing well in general. There are good things that have come out so far. They just need to get back to doing that.
I think they've missed some opportunities this set. They've had some chances to be patient and set the ball up for a kill, and instead would try to dink it over when perhaps they could have been a little more patient. So I'd like to see them take their time and try to set the ball up a little bit more.
Yep, Michaela Carpenter back to serve from the Foresters. Bring it up and out. Good eye there by Erin Carlos. She was almost going to go for the dig. Last second decided to duck out of the way. Well played there by Carlos.
Good decision. It was close.
Peyton Anderson back to serve. And service error. Not what the Pilots needed to see.
Just can't afford that. Especially when you're behind and trying to get back in it.
Burwell back to serve for Huntington. Serve clean. Off the block. Audrey Mallers.
Yeah, and I thought the Pilots set that up well. Just a good block.
Great Anderson. Wolfenbarger had some heat on it, but brought home Mallers. Oh. Carlos with the dig, but nothing doing there for the Pilots. Just couldn't bring it back.
Yeah, it was a nice dig, but
Huntington is now doubled up, 16-8.
Ouch.
And the run is on, folks. 17-8. Wolfenbarger not able to handle that one.
That shouldn't happen. Just just drop right in front of her.
Peyton Anderson set up. Sandra Williams tips it over the net. Chipping away slowly but surely. They're getting there. Sandra Williams, nice little soft tip over the net. See if that's the spark Bethel needed. Katie Easter back to serve. She's been reliable. Kate Cobb with the dig. Brings it up. And not able to handle it. There's Williams. Huntington seems to be keeping up the deficit at 18-9 right now as Bibier comes back into the game. Wolfenbarger able to bring it home, showing some emotion after that point. She's not done yet.
There's that senior leadership you were talking about.
Definitely showing some emotion. She has the killer instinct, as we've seen. Carlos back to serve, gets it over Kate Cobb. Kobe sets it up and brought home by Mallers. Pilots seem to be starting to find their footing there, but momentum quickly brought back into Huntington's favor. Served by Mallers, Peyton Anderson sets up. Haley Brown, too much on it again. The Pilots are giving away way too much in this set. The mistakes are adding up as Huntington is up to a comfortable 20-10 lead. Carlos the serve, and Wolfenbarger able to tip it over. Well done there.
Beautiful.
By Wolfenbarger.
Vegas putting the team on her back right now, trying to get them over the hump here.
That's what you like to see from your upperclassmen. Now she's back to serve. Serve received nicely. Number 10, Ashley Drew, is able to take that one over. That's a kill for Huntington. 21-11 now. As Vegas coming off, being replaced by Meg Gabbard, sophomore from Granger, Indiana. Kate Cobb takes the serve over. Carlos able to bring it up, just has to set it over, free ball. And the block is on there. There's a set for Haley Brown, well done there.
Good position. Good position, good timing.
Like I said before, we've seen some good things from the Pilots here and there. It's just flashes of greatness. They haven't been able to maintain it as time goes on. Kristen Mitchell to serve now. Serve received ball by Mallers. Hubby. And blocked. Haley Brown and Amanda Brinkman on the block there. Bethel starting to chip away at this lead slowly but surely. Kristen Mitchell back to serve again.
There's an opportunity here.
Serve. It's a free ball. See a net violation by Peyton Anderson on that one. 22-13 is the score now. As Huntington just needs three more points to bring this set home and take it 1-1. Anderson set up to Brinkman.
Nice.
They're not done yet, folks. Brinkman brings that one home. 22-14, and in comes Cassandra Williams. Haley Brown back to serve. And the block is there again. Williams feeling it after that point. We've seen some very good defensive plays from the Pilots so far this game, and they're kind of coming back to life now. Haley Brown coming back again.
Oh.
And the service error kills the momentum.
That's too bad.
Just when they were starting to put it together, all comes crashing down again. Like building a house of cards outside on a windy day.
Huh.
Brinkman brings it over, and solo block by Danielle Gerwell again. That puts it up to set point, 24-15. Williams. And that is the set just out of bounds. 25-15 final for that set. It is now 1-1. Oh, seems like the officials are talking about it for a moment.
They're trying to determine.
And it is deemed in. Touched.
It was touched.
Touched by Huntington. That's a break there for the Pilots. See if they can keep the momentum going in this one. Peyton Anderson back there to serve. See if they can keep it up. Lucky break there. Thin serve received nicely. And the block is there again. That's a point. 17-24. Chipping away at it slowly but surely. They're getting there.
Cassandra Williams has been tough up front.
Phenomenal in the blocking game. Anderson back to serve. Up and over.
Nice
there's
dig.
Another dig by Carlos. Hits it over. Free ball. Mallers block is there by, Brinkman not able to get there. Set point goes to Huntington, 25-17.
Great effort by Amanda Brinkman, but just couldn't get to it.
Just not quite. And like we said before, going into the break, it's 1-1, and they're getting there. They're showing flashes of great things, good defense, great blocking by Cassandra Williams, Vegas, Kristen Mitchell, everyone showing great things from that aspect of the game. Just the mental mistakes killed it for the Pilots in that set. This is very evident in the second one.
Yeah, those last 10 points, they really started playing well. They just got off to such a poor start. They dug themselves too big of a hole and couldn't get out of it.
Definitely. I don't have a stat sheet in front of me, but I would say a good maybe 10 points came off mental mistakes in that set. And that you just can't have that high of a number when you're trying to beat a quality team, especially at the Foresters, and when there's so much on the line in this game, fourth place and a good standing as you roll through the season and try to get to the tournament. So we go into the break with some things to figure out for the Pilots.
Yeah, I think just consistency, avoiding those mental errors and having a little more patience when they get a free ball.
Definitely, and communication is key. We've seen a few little mistakes with miscommunication. They don't know who's gonna get the ball, who's got it. The block doesn't know who hit it or who to get it up. So it's the little things, it really is the little things that make the big things so much better. And if you can't do the little things right, it's the fundamentals that you see are mistakes. Serves into the net, the set's not going over clean, the dig's not helping out and going back over for another free ball. It's those little things that you see here and there, it's just fundamentals that you just can't have those errors if you want to be a winning volleyball team.
Yeah, and they've had those same struggles all year, but they're still in a pretty good position in the Crossroads League, as we've talked about earlier. They're 4-4 or 4-6,
Huntington
have an opportunity if they can beat Huntington to move up in the standings a little bit, because Huntington's only 5-5, so, and I think there's like three teams at 4-6, so there's an opportunity to move up with a win tonight. They're in pretty good shape to make the Crossroads League tournament, but they just need to win these games that they can win.
Definitely, and when going into the break, tied 1-1, Bethel is 500 on the season, 3-3, 3-3. Now we have the stats here from that second set for Huntington University. Kills were led by Aubrey Mallers, who has been taking over for them, but it was pretty well spread out too. Josie Bevier brings it in, and also Ashley Drews, Haley Longley, and Danielle Gerwell. for the Pilots, the kills were pretty well spread out as well. Aaron Carlos with one. Cassandra Williams and Vegas, two apiece. Amanda Brinkman with one as well. But just too many mental mistakes from the Pilots in that last set to be able to bring it home. They showed some fire in the end, definitely something that you can build off of going into the break, saying, hey, you've seen some good, you've done some good things. You shot yourselves in the foot to this point. You took the first set, you minimized the mistakes, you did that well. You did good things going in. So now it's just a matter of saying, hey, let's eliminate these little things, let's get back out there and take it and do well. And blocks in the second set for Pilots, led by Brinkman and Haley Brown, two apiece for them. And the block play has been very good for the Pilots all night. Cassandra Williams contributing.
Yeah, where we dropped off a little bit was in our defense. We had 20 digs in the first set and only six in the second. You know, maybe it was just Huntington playing better and providing some strong shots, but needed to be in position better than we were, and just needed a little better effort defensively.
Definitely. And you see, defensively it needs to be there and the mental mistakes need to be eliminated. But when you go into that set, I think if I were Coach Weekend, a little bit of fire, get under them, got a fire under them, say, hey, this is our house. Right now at home, we are 1-7. That is abysmal. Rochelle Weekend's in her first season. She's building things around her program. But when you're building a system, you're building your program up, you have to say, hey, first thing we need to establish, we need to win at home. People need to be afraid to come into Goodman Gym and say, we're going to need to work. We're going to need to make them work if they want to have a win here. And you just can't say that right now, since given the standings, 1-7 at home so far. And it's, you just need to see better work output at home from Coach Wiegand. You need to light a fire and say, hey, this is our house. We need to protect it. So now you see, this is a very pivotal game as well. Bethel comes in 4-6, standing in that eighth spot in the conference. And Huntington at that fifth spot. They're 4-6 to 5-5. That could be, this game could potentially be the difference between Bethel being in eighth and fourth place.
Yeah, look at that bunch. I mean, Grace, Huntington, Marion, Goshen, and Bethel. You know, Grace and Huntington both at 5-5, but Marion, Goshen, and Bethel all at 4-6. So it's still a scramble for that fourth spot. You know, Indiana Wesleyan and Mount Vernon Nazarene, of course, look to be the clear leaders and the class of the league. But getting into the top four and having the home opportunity in the Crossroads League tournament play is still an still possible for Bethel.
Definitely,
you know, they get a win here, and a couple more wins, and they could sneak into that fourth spot.
Definitely, they are not out of it yet, and that's what they kind of got to say. We're not out yet. We're playing like we have nothing to play for. They're playing for something very important, and that's that home spot in the tournament. So you definitely come out. You look at your, like we said earlier, you look at your seniors. You look at Wolfenbarger. You look at Amanda Brinkman, and you see how things work and how they're kind of going through and say, we got to do better. We got to get better and move on from all the little mistakes. Get those out of your head. You have to have a short memory.
Hey, Andrew, I just want to let our viewers know about our coverage Friday as Bethel takes on Davenport. The Bethel Sports Network will provide live coverage this Friday at 7:00. Another game where Bethel can improve their home record and hopefully get a win against Davenport.
It is a non-conference matchup for the Pilots, so just for the overall win percentage, and get that win at home, kind of getting ready back for Crossroads League play. As the next game is against Davenport University, like you said. Then they bring in St. Francis, who is not doing well in the conference, 2-8 so far. But after that, it'd be nice to get a conference win, kind of get a little bit of a streak. You see, if you can get the win tonight against Huntington, you have Davenport next. And then if you can get that win, Davenport's at home. They're coming in, so you see them. And yeah. Then St. Francis, who is not overly fantastic, you can say, hey, we're going to get a win here. We can hopefully get a win. And you can get a little streak going before you head into the tournament. Pilots coming back onto the court now, looking focused.
They got a difficult month coming up after the St. Francis game. A couple of nationally ranked teams in Viterbo and University of Jamestown and Grandview University, all ranked in the top 25 of the NAIA. Then they get into five. They end the season with five tough Crossroads League games with Taylor, Goshen, Spring Arbor, Indiana Wesleyan, at Indiana Wesleyan, and at Mount Vernon to end the season, the top two teams on the road. So, again, that just makes you more aware how important this game is, and then the game with St. Francis. Got to beat those teams you can beat.
Definitely. Once you get those little, I don't want to call them gimme games per se, but those games that on paper are a little bit easier.
At least 50-50, right? Especially at home, you'd think.
Definitely. You've seen even when the Pilots are doing well, when they're communicating well and they're getting points and they're getting on a run, this crowd is into it. They are behind them 100%. So it's got to see when they come out of the break if they can come out and perform to the standard that can get this crowd going, can get them a little confidence, get a run going, get the momentum on their side. Right. Now, we'll see if they can pull it out. If Rochelle Wiegand's words at the half, at the intermission, have really rained true. On the court right now, we have Cassandra Williams, Haley Brown, Amanda Brinkman, Peyton Anderson, Kristen Mitchell, and Zoe Wolfenbarger. Also on the libero spot, Aaron Carlos. Haley Brown will serve to start this third set. Set up, Brinkman brings some heat on that one. That's a point for the Pilots. That's what they needed coming out into this third set. Some heat there by Brinkman. Brown serve, gets it over the net. That's an ace.
Nice serve.
Definitely looking like the start Coach Wiegand was looking for. Some fire on the sideline as well. Brown serve and service error. That's not what they needed there. Beating themselves, like we said, fundamentals. Just got to get it over the net. You're trying to do too much when you're trying to bring heat with the serve. Mallers back. Turned by Mitchell. Brinkman brings some heat. And there it is. 3-1 start for the Pilots.
Nice play.
See if they can keep that momentum rolling. Peyton Anderson back to serve now.
Nicely executed.
Hovey gets the serve. And error there by Taylor Schultius.
That was awful. That looked like me out there.
I think you might have done a little bit better with that one.
It happens.
Anderson back to serve. And she gets it back, gets it over the net. Anderson with the set. Brinkman tips it over. Nice dig there. Out. Ball there by Taylor Schultius is out. And Pilots now up 5-1. This was the start they were looking for. Get a little momentum on their side, get some heat. Heating up, crowd's kind of warming up, getting into it. Hubby sets it up for Schultius, and Schultius brings it home. 5-2 now. Coming in now for Foresters is number 5, Danielle Gerwell, trying to help out that front line. Cobb back to serve. Anderson, Cassandra Williams brings that one home. Into that 5 zone. Kitty Easter serve, gets it over the net, return well. Hubby sets it up. Off the block there, they call a net violation. A lift actually on Huntington. Pilots up 7-2, Katie Easter back to serve. This was the opening they were looking for coming out of the intermission.
Absolutely.
Hubby sets it up and Bevier brings it home, no. Anderson to Wolfenbarger. Hubby sets up again, Schultius, and Schultius is able to get it done, bring it home. Good effort there by Katie Easter, just not enough on it.
I thought we missed an opportunity there, had a chance for a nice set and an opportunity for a spike and just didn't get it.
Brianna Levings now to serve for Huntington. Wolfenbarger. Not sure if that was an error by Wolfenbarger or just a really good block by Huntington, but either way, point goes to Huntington. Levings back to serve. Turned well, Anderson sets up. Tip over by Mitchell and just can't get over. Good effort there by Aaron Carlos. Just couldn't get it over there by from Mitchell. Had to try and step over her teammate there. 7-5 now the score. And that is out. Good eye by Aaron Carlos again.
Yeah, at the last second, she just pulled off that.
She's been showing incredibly good decision-making as the game goes on.
Now we need a good serve from her.
From the libero, she gets through. Up they go. Gerwell able to bring that one home. A little shaky off the block.
Haley Brown jumped a little too early there. She was on her way down.
Just missed time to jump there.
Just mistimed it.
Michaela Carpenter back to serve for Huntington. Brings it up. Katie Easter returns it. Peyton Anderson there. Haley Brown to take it home. But it's just out. 8-7. More of these outs. More of these little mental errors. Kind of showing up again for the Pilots.
And we don't know how healthy Haley Brown is. As, you know, she's taped up. And we're not sure if she's 100% or what her situation is.
Kristen Mitchell there, able to get it touched by Huntington. Brings it up to 9-7 Bethel. And here she is, Vegas back to serve now, seeing if she can keep the momentum in Bethel's favor. Kind of a smaller lineup for Bethel now as Brinkman and Williams are on the sideline. Easter not able to get that one over. Gerwell back to serve, gets it over, returned by Easter, and not able to be tracked down. Seemed to be a little bit of miscommunication there between Carlos and Easter. Didn't know who was going to return that one.
Yeah, too bad, because that wasn't a real difficult play.
Easter able to handle that one. Anderson brings up. Mitchell able to get the point for Bethel.
Nice.
10-9, right when they needed it, and in comes Brinkman. Trying to get a little bit more front line help there for Haley Brown. Cobb able to return that one, set up, and quick spike by Ashley Drews. Serve off the net, Anderson able to corral it. And Haley Brown to bring that one home with some authority. That one had some heat on it.
Now she needs to serve. She's been a little bit inconsistent with her serve.
She's got to calm down, get it over the net, and she does. Hubby sets it up. Mallard sends it over and set over again. Missed opportunity there from Bethel, but they bring it home. Touched by Huntington. 12-10 now the score. Well done, Brown to serve, and like we said, she's been a little inconsistent, but gets it over the net there. What else does she has to do? Hubby sets it up. Bivier gets it, and point for Bethel. A lift called on Huntington.
Keep serving well. Don't give them a point here.
Peyton Anderson set up.
Nice.
Cassandra Williams, another set for her. That's another kill for Williams.
I'd like to see Bethel do more of that. Take their time, be patient, allow the play to develop.
Hubby sets it up, and Bivier hits a brick wall there. Williams with another block.
Perfectly timed.
Going into the huddle after that point. They're feeling it right now. Bethel up 15-10. 10 more points brings this third set home, and then a service error from Haley Brown.
Just get it over.
It's all you got to do, folks. Easier said than done, as we're seeing here. Mallard's serve gets it over, returned by Wolfenbarger. Set up by Anderson. Kristen Mitchell able to get it, but a net violation, it looks like, on Bethel. Point Huntington. Brinkman
wow,
able to
nice.
Bring that one home just off of the forearm to Kate Cobb.
She couldn't get out of the way.
Couldn't get out of the way of that one. That one had some heat. Well done there. Off the block, Carlos able to get it. Anderson puts it up, and Wolfenbarger return there. Cobb sets it up, brought back over, and out. Oh, no, point touched by Bethel. Off the fingertips of the blocker there. Kate Cobb back to serve for Huntington. Set up there by Hubby, well received. Cobb has set it over. Free
There's
ball for the Pilots. This is an opportunity you were talking about.
Nice.
And brought home by Amanda Brinkman. Exactly what they needed there.
Nicely done.
Katie Easter back to serve for the Pilots, up 17-13. Hubby sets it up, brings it over. Point Bethel, well done there. 18-13 now the score. Bethel playing very well in this third set. Easter up, ball gets over on the serve. Hubby sets up, Bivier tips right over. Good vision there from Bivier.
Aaron Carlos diving for that, but just a little bit out of her reach.
I wouldn't sweat it, though, if I were her. She's been playing very well tonight. Serve received by Mitchell. Peyton Anderson gets it over. Just have to set it over. Free ball there for Huntington. Tipped over by Durwell. Well played there by Carlos. Cobb sets over. Had to bring it over. Katie Easter
nice.
Gets it there. Wolfenbarger to Mitchell. Tips over. The third step to get it over by Cobb. Good rally here for the bat for the
there
Pilots.
It is.
Wolfenbarger
nice.
Brings it home. That's what you needed to see if you were the Pilots. You got the momentum in your favor. You're able to go on a long rally, communicate well, and then Wolfenbarger, that killer instinct to bring it home. Well done.
And they're having some fun.
Definitely.
Smiling.
They got those fundamentals down, and the first word in fundamentals is fun. And received and brought just over the net by Paige Eakright. Well done there by Huntington.
Yeah, that was a good shot.
Score is now 19-15. Bethel is up. And Michaela Carpenter back to serve for Huntington. Up we go, Easter to Peyton Anderson, and Mitchell sent it over. Just a mental mistake from Mitchell, not what they were looking for. Gotta get that ball over the net.
She's played so well, but just mishit that one.
Definitely, now Carpenter back to serve again for the Foresters. Anderson to Brown.
Brown up.
Carlos playing well. Mitchell to put some heat on that one. Brought over and just meets the open zone by Haley Longley. Timeout. Rochelle Wiegand looking to get a little talking to going for her ladies. Very good set so far from Bethel, but they're kind of losing it. That's why we got the timeout.
Yeah, I think a good timeout.
But they're playing with passion. They're showing a little bit of enthusiasm. They're having a little bit of fun. But you can have fun. You just can't take your foot off the gas. And they had them there for a while now. So see if they can come out of this timeout, get that fire back, and say, hey, let's quit the fooling around. Let's bring it home, and then we can celebrate after we get a win.
Yeah.
Too much celebrating on the court.
And sometimes just an opportunity to catch your breath.
Definitely after that long rally there where Zoe Wolfenbarger was able to bring it home. Vegas made a great play on that one just to put some heat on it, get it into that back corner, and really take it home. And the block is playing well. The blockers are doing their job. Everyone is doing their job, and that's what you like to see. The service errors have been brought down to a minimum in this set. Now we're just looking for some consistency.
Yep.
That's the name of the game. That's the word of the day, consistency for the Pilots. See if the serves can go over the net every time. If they can get the ball over. We saw one error from Kristen Mitchell. But now we come back into it off the timeout. Michaela Carpenter back to serve for Huntington. Gets it over Anderson there. Wolfenbarger to tip it over, and well done there to bring it back. That's a free ball for the Pilots, though. And Haley Brown able
nice.
To get it over. Well done. 20-17 is the score now. Wolfenbarger back to serve. And that's a timeout, Huntington. Huntington coach Kyle Shondell did not like what he saw there. He had to call a timeout to regroup.
Yeah, whatever Coach Wiegand says during the timeouts, it seems to work, because it seems like most of the night, every time after a timeout, Bethel has come out and played well. And they've executed, and typically almost every time have gotten a point. So,
definitely, and when they see the huddle and the timeout, it seems very loose and easy, very easygoing. Everyone's talking to each other while Coach Wiegand talks to her assistants, and then she comes in, and watch, you can see it here. Focus is in. As soon as she comes in, she commands their attention. And she says, hey, this is what we need to do. We need to keep going. Have some fun, but don't loosen up. You can have fun and keep that grip tight.
Right.
So I think that's what she's preaching right now. And Shondell getting his girls together saying, let's not get too far behind now. Pilots coming back out of the timeout. They're high-fiving. They're saying, hey, we're doing good. Let's bring this home. They are 5 points away from going up 2-1 in the series right now. Wolfenbarger back to serve. Now she has been consistent.
Really need a good serve here.
Gets it over there. Set up. And just a tip over by Haley Longley. Sometimes that little tip's all you need. You don't need to bring heat on every single hit. It's the mix-up game that you need to
right.
get that little tip over.
Especially when the blockers are at the net. Just tip it over them.
Mm-hmm. And a service error there. No momentum for Danielle Gerwell.
That's a break we needed.
Back in Bethel's favor, 28 21-18, rather. Kristen Mitchell back to serve for the Pilots. Pitt Cobb sets it up, tip over. Peyton Anderson sets up, and Wolfenbarger puts some heat on it, bring it home.
Nice.
There's the point Bethel was looking for, fired up. Wolfenbarger is a senior, and she shows when she gets a kill, when she gets that point that she needs, she is all stomping around, having some fun, getting showing the emotion.
Yeah, that was a tough shot from the middle zone, too.
Definitely.
She got a lot on it.
And now we're looking at it, three more points. Bethel's got this set, and they're up 2-1. So going in for another timeout. Coach Wiegand's in, and watch again, the focus all business. It's fun and games until Coach Wiegand sits in that middle of that huddle, then it is business.
Yeah, and in the other huddle, they have to be talking about some of the same things. I mean, they're still in this. They've had some inconsistent play as well.
Definitely some mental errors.
Yeah,
that you
service into the net that kind of hurt them.
Yeah, that you didn't see in the first,
not
before
in the second
the intermission.
Set,
yeah.
Yeah,
they were playing a sound game, but now Coach Kyle Shondell's got to say, hey, let's get back to where we were before. I don't know what's gotten into you, but. I'll stop it there. Kristen Mitchell back to serve for the Pilots. Mallers takes it, and just like we said, that little tip over is all you need sometimes. 22-19 is the score now, and Huntington chipping away at it. See how the Pilots respond to that. Hubby back to serve. Carlos returns it. Anderson, and brought home by Amanda Brinkman. Showing some senior leadership of her own.
Yeah, she got up.
And in comes Cassandra Williams. Miscommunication on the return from Huntington, but they were able to bring it back.
Oh,
Mallard,
nice save by Haley Brown.
Nice dig there. Violation called on Bethel. That's a point for Huntington. 23-20 is now the score. Bethel is 2 points away from bringing this one home. Continue playing, Mallers to serve, gets it over, Mitchell turns it to Anderson, and Brinkman too much. Wait a minute, looks like they said it was touched.
Oh, I wasn't sure about that. Huntington coach isn't so sure either.
Set point, according to the officials, it was touched. At the end of the day, it's their opinion that matters most. Peyton Anderson sets it over, serves it over. And Viviera brings it home. Oh. Dig there for Aaron Carlos. More off her shoulder than off her arms, though. Kind of took the heat on that one. 24-21 is the score. Now you have to win a set by two.
Right.
So Huntington's able to close this gap, but you could see it go over 25.
Right,
but Cassandra Williams is going to bring it home. Pilots up now 2-1, and they are feeling it after that third set. Coming out of the intermission, coming out of the timeouts, they are doing well. They're keeping it going. So they're minimizing the mental mistakes, as we've said time and time again. They're minimizing those and really playing sound volleyball, and that's just all it takes. They're fundamentally sound, doing what they have to do. And Huntington seems to kind of have lost that edge that they kind of had coming in and going into the intermission in that second set. So see how it goes from there, from here on out.
Yeah, it's like any sport. You know, there's momentum, and Bethel clearly has the momentum now. They look good that set.
Definitely.
Good execution.
Kind of you see throughout, the momentum was kind of going back and forth, but once it got into Bethel's favor, they were just hammering at home in that third set. Well played. Now Now we go into this little intermission, 2 minutes left in it. And Huntington's players kind of talking to each other, saying, hey, come on, guys, we gotta get it together here. We can't lose another set. We're out of here. Right. And that's what shifts the momentum in Bethel's favor for the most part. One more set, you get to go home. You're done. You get to go home with a win. You're feeling good, feeling happy. Coach Wiegand's telling her girls that too, like, hey, we got to get home. We got to bring it home. I'm sure you guys have homework to do or something. You got to hit the books hard tonight. So they're kind of doing it. They're doing their thing. And really, it's a well-played set so far. As we get our stats for the set.
Right, and as we've talked about throughout the night, Bethel is only 1-7 at home this year. So this is really an opportunity to get a home win. And you know, being up 2-1, they really need to take advantage of this.
And that killer instinct being shown in the third set as leading the team in kills for that set. Amanda Brinkman brought it in that set, folks. 6 kills for her. 3 for Cassandra Williams, 2 for Haley Brown, Zoe Wolfenbarger and Kristen Mitchell also with 2. But you also saw it in digs. They did well with their dig game. Kristen Mitchell, Aaron Carlos, 2 in that one, 2 apiece. Also Haley Brown with 2. And then 1 apiece for Katie Easter and Amanda Brinkman. Brinkman was really all over the floor for that.
Peyton Anderson with 14 assists.
That's what you like to see from your setter. Getting her set up, getting that spiker to bring it home. Also on the Huntington side in kills, 3 for Aubrey Mallers, who's been playing very well tonight. And then 2 apiece for Josie Bevier, Taylor Schultheus, and Haley Longley. And then 1 for Paige Eakright, Ashley Drews, and Danielle Gerwell. As we come back out onto the floor for this fourth and potentially final set. If Huntington is able to pull out this set, they will go into a fifth one, and that fifth set goes to 15 instead of 25. The margin for error is that much shorter.
Yeah, so, we want to try to avoid that fifth set.
So Bethel needs to bring this one home. Set brought over. Set up. Brinkman picks up where she left off. Able to bring some heat there. That's another kill for her.
She's feeling it.
She is feeling it right now, showing that senior leadership some emotion coming off for that last one. That's what we like to see. Pilots go off to the start 1-0. Peyton Anderson there. Pips it up. Kate Cobb able to return it to Hubby. Bevier brings it over the block. Anderson to set. Williams able to bring it home. She's not going to question how that one worked out, but she'll take the points. 2-0 now. Anderson back to serve.
Again, Bethel smiling, having fun, playing well. Nice to see.
Out. Oh, never mind. That hit the line. Touched there by the Pilots. Bethel. Good break for Huntington now as Aubrey Mallers back to serve for the Foresters. Coming up, Kristen Mitchell, Peyton Anderson, and then Wolfenbarger hits a brick wall on that one, but point to the Pilots, 3-1. Miscommunication by Huntington, but they're able to get it together, get it back over. Anderson and Williams mistimes the jump on that. Miscommunication between Anderson and Williams. Score is now 3-2. Cobb back to serve, gets it over. Easter serve. And then Mitchell able to get it over and brings it home for the Pilots. 4-2 now the score. Pilots are having a pretty solid set so far as Haley Brown comes in for Cassandra Williams.
Aaron Carlos back to serve.
She's also done well tonight serving. Hubby sets it up, Bevier. Anderson up, and Mitchell sends it over. good block. Anderson and Wolfenbarger bringing it nice. Home. Point there, double hit from Huntington.
Nice play by Vegas, though.
Vegas showing that killer instinct that she has. Winning that one-on-one matchup. Cobb sets it up. And Ekright able to take it over, but it's out. Point
out.
For the Pilots. 6-2 now, Pilots on a roll. Timeout, Huntington. Pilots have some very good conversation to have on this timeout as they're going into it 6-2. And Kyle Shondell does not look too happy with his girls at the moment. They are not playing with that fire that we saw out of before the intermission and a little bit in the last set.
Bethel's playing well.
Bethel's playing, definitely playing well. They've eliminated the mental mistakes. They're coming together. They're playing good volleyball. And now they just want to bring it home. And they're all together right now. They're a team. They're close. They're saying, hey, it's right in front of us. They're not going to hand it to us. We got to go out there and we got to take it. And it can definitely be done. It's not out of reach. They're playing good volleyball, and when you play good volleyball and play fundamentally sound, you can win the game. You can take it home and go home with a 3-1 win. That can definitely set you up for greater things in the future as they go to their next game against Davenport on Friday, which we will be covering on the Bethel Sports Network. And then St. Francis afterwards. Coming out of the timeout, they're high-fiving. They're having some fun on the Bethel side. So we'll see how they can do coming out of the timeout. In the past, they've done pretty well coming out of the timeouts. They've had some fire. They've been showing they can really put it together out of the timeouts. Whatever Rochelle Wiegand says to them, it really speaks.
Yeah, and they've maintained the momentum they got from the last set. They're playing well. See if they can keep it going.
And Carlos Hubby brings it over. And
nice
block there.
Really Brown.
Well done. Right over Danielle Gerwell. Couldn't do it. 7-2. Pilots coming out. Back to serve for the Pilots is Aaron Carlos. 8-2 is the score for the Pilots. The serve well, Hubby to Gerwell, and Gerwell brings it home for Huntington. Huntington playing well coming out of the timeout as well. Anderson, Wolfenbarger brings it up. Return well, set over, free ball for the Pilots. Anderson sets it up, Brown tips it right over, and that's a point for the Pilots, 9-3.
Nicely placed.
The score now, very good placement there for the Pilots. Now Vegas back to serve again. She's shown she can be consistent in the serving game. Over the net, received well by Huntington. Set up, and the block comes out. Peyton Anderson and Haley Brown on that one. That ball looked like it hit a brick wall, bounced right back at her.
Yeah, Haley Brown was all over that. Bethel is really having fun, really playing well.
They are feeling it going into this timeout. Manson smiling, high-fiving all night long. Definitely good defensive play in that little bit of a little run there. Good defensive play, the block playing well, timing the jumps, getting it done.
Yeah, look at their huddle. I mean, they're all having fun, they're laughing, but they're playing well too, so.
Definitely, you can see it.
I haven't seen them like this year, where they're smiling, you know, and really, really enjoying themselves.
Really playing well overall. And you see it from them, they're doing good plays, they're communicating well. They have a lot to smile about over there as the score is 10-3. So, what you see, and look at them now, they're huddled together. They're saying, hey, we're a team, we're one, we're together in this.
Yeah, they've been doing this a lot.
Get there and bring it home. Put that on a t-shirt somewhere for Bethel Volleyball. Bring it home. That home record is looking so far, if they can keep the momentum in their favor, to go up to 2-7, chip away at it, make it very hard to win here in Goodman Gym. Have some pride in that. Have some home pride. And Vegas back to serve again, as she has stayed consistent for them.
Yeah, we need some good serves from Vegas. She usually delivers.
Out there. Point for the Pilots. They'll take the points where they can get them. That is an ace for Vegas.
Nice serve. That was close.
Right
in the corner.
Able to get that line. Let's see if Vegas can pull off pocket aces on this one.
This is that senior leadership you were talking about.
High floating serve set up nicely. Oh, the block.
Nice dig by Carlos.
Wolfenbarger able to take it over. Vegas going. There, Brown able to set it over. Vegas with the dig. Hangs it up, got to get it over. Free ball there for Huntington. Set up, Eathright. Point for the Pilots, double hit. Well played rally there for the Pilots.
Bethel's really playing well.
They are feeling it right now as Vegas comes back.
Need another good serve here.
Vegas is doing very well in the serving game. Set it up. Gerwell mistimes the jump, and that's another point for the Pilots. Like I said, we'll take them where we can get them.
Huntington's in trouble. Coach Shandell might think about a timeout here.
Vegas is picking her spots in the serving game, picking them apart. And more mental errors from Huntington. 15-3 now. Coach Shandell not thinking about a timeout yet. Subs come in. Taylor Schultheus and Callie Collins coming in for Huntington. See if they can get some fresh bodies in there for some better play.
Yeah, they need some kind of spark.
The Bethel sideline is feeling right now. Wolfenbarger not gambling with their serves there. Vegas doing very well. Getting it over, getting their spot. Returned well. Anderson gets it over. And they just have to set it over. Anderson up. Haley Brown trying to bring it home, but the block is there. Kristen Mitchell takes it over. Set up.
What a
very well played. Wolfenbarger brings it over. Cobb with the dive. Nice dig there. And brought home by Huntington.
Both teams played well on that.
Very good rally there on both sides. Back to serve for Huntington. Number two, Michaela Carpenter, seems she can get the momentum on Huntington's side, start chipping away at this lead. Kristen Mitchell brings it over. Mallers takes it over. Set up by Anderson to Mitchell, tip over the block, and out. Wait, yep, that is out. Bethel up 17-4.
16-4.
16-4, that's my fault. I just get so excited.
You're anticipating.
Yeah. Kristen Mitchell back to serve now. See if she can follow up Wolfenbarger. And Huntington able to get the point there, chipping away slowly but surely at this lead. 17-4.
Did they give the wrong point to Huntington? Had that point. It was just 16-4. Should be 16-5.
Yeah, a little bit of a scoreboard error there.
Our score is correct on the screen.
And brought home there. Official talking to the scorecard.
Should be 17-5.
And looks like they're fixing it. Coach Wiegand giving a look over to that scoring table. She knows the momentum's all in her team's favor and getting it to kind of cool down here as you try to get the right scoring is a bit frustrating.
Right. When you're playing well, you just want to keep playing. You don't want anything
definitely
to stop it.
Want to ride that hot hand and keep
this is
going.
A break they didn't need. Huntington probably appreciates it.
Probably Huntington bringing it together and saying, hey, we got to get the lead out here. On the floor right now for Bethel, we have Peyton Anderson, Cassandra Williams, Amanda Brinkman, Vegas, Haley Brown, and Kristen Mitchell. And for Huntington on the floor, it is Michaela Carpenter, Brianna Levings, Ashley Drews, Audrey Mallers, Kate Cobb, and Haley Longley, I believe. Haley Brown back to serve for the Pilots side.
We're still debating the score here.
I think the look on Rochelle Wiegand's face says it all. She's not pleased.
There we go.
There we go. We're getting it now.
We had it right all along.
Should have just talked to us about the Sports Network. Seems to know where it's at. Brown serves it over. Set up. Good dig there by Brown. Vegas brings it over. Brinkman. Mallard takes it over. Haley Brown takes it in the face, but brings it and not able to get it over there for Brinkman. Rare mistake from her tonight. 17-6 is the score now.
Bethel can't relax here.
Serve goes just over, and that's an ace for Huntington.
That's a tough break. Hits the net, just kind of rolls over.
Yep. Now there seems to be a pause for some moisture on the court.
This isn't the NBA where the towel boys run out there and wipe it all up, right?
Yeah. Volleyball, you do it yourself. Yo, Brinkman answers, tries to bring it home there, but well received. Good tip over the block by Mallers. And brought home by Peyton Anderson. No sets there. Like you said, those little quick sets, those little quick dumps over the net. She finds that zone, that open area, gets him out of position and brings it home. That's killer instinct right there. Now Anderson back to serve. Well played. Hubby sets it up, and Viviere tries to bring it home, but
nice dig.
Carlos is there, and Wolfenbarger brings some heat on that one. Kate Cobb's able to knock it up, brings it over. Free ball for the Pilots. Carlos up, and Kristen Mitchell just has to take it home. Looks like some miscommunication there. We'll see how it goes. Viviere tips over and finds the open zone behind the block. Huntington on a little bit of a roll now. 18-8 is the score. The block is there. Well done by Huntington. Viviere and Drews were there. Timeout Bethel. Coach Wiegand saying, hey, let's not let this get away from us now. We are 7 points away from a victory. Let's get the momentum back. Come on now, guys. sure she says it a little bit more formally than that, but
right.
The gist is there. And here we are back in Bethel's huddle. They're laughing. They're kind of a little bit more serious tone. They're talking to each other and saying, hey, we got to get together. And now, bam, focus. Eyes on me, says Rochelle Wiegand. She's laughing a little bit. She's
trying to loosen them up a little.
Yeah.
Maybe they're playing a little tight. So close to their second home win this season.
Bringing out on the floor for the Pilots, Cassandra Williams, Amanda Brinkman, Vegas, Aaron Carlos, and Kristen Mitchell, and Peyton Anderson back out there. 18-9 is the score. Audrey Mahler's back for Huntington to serve. Mitchell receives it well, set up.
Oh, that was a.
And that's a point. Double hit there. Tough break for the Pilots, but it's now 18-10. And Williams able to bring it home on that one. Some heat. Fell out of bounds, but touched by the block on Huntington. Katie Easter back to serve for the Pilots. Pilots are now 6 points away from bringing this one home a little early. And over.
Oh.
Opportunity there for Kristen Mitchell. Passed up. Hits it out of bounds.
A good try. She just missed it.
The idea was there to hit it down the line, but. Barger. Put up Hubby. Carlos just couldn't get there. Point there for Huntington. The Huntington fans getting back into it a little bit. Kate Cobb back to serve for Huntington.
Taylor Schopels from Elkhart seems to have a few fans here for Huntington.
Kate Cobb also from Elkhart. Fun fact, Kate Cobb's dad was my 8th grade math teacher.
No kidding.
True story, I can see him over there in the stands. A little shout out to Mr. Cobb.
Trying to teach you math.
It was a struggle. It was. I tried my best. Now back to the action. Peyton Anderson sets up Kristen Mitchell. And it hits the rafters and down. Good effort there by Cobb. Carlos back to serve, sends it over. And can't do anything with it. That'll be an ace for Carlos. Bethel is now 4 points from bringing it home. And they're feeling.
Just nip the net. Did it look like it just nipped the net a little
just
bit
nipped
there?
Nipped the net a little bit, but.
Made it difficult for them to judge.
Go brought over. And there for Belvedere, but. And Carlos brings it up. Brown takes it home. 3 points. It's right in front of you, Bethel. You just gotta take it. And they are doing it right now. Aaron Carlos back to serve again. They are not letting up. Serve well received by Mallers. Eichmann there, bring it down the line. Wolfenbarger.
It's in.
That is in. 23-12 is the score now. Pilots are feeling it.
Yeah, they're playing well.
This is the volleyball we've been looking to see all season. Aaron Carlos to serve again. Well received by Mallers to Hubby. Eichmann to tip it over, and that's a point for, or Schulte has tipped it over. My fault, folks. Taylor Schulte takes it over. 23-13 is the score. Up. Mitchell takes it over, well received by Mahlers. And hitting the open zone is Danielle Gerwell for Huntington. Well played. We'll get a miscommunication on the return. Some emotion coming out from the Huntington side as it is now 23-15 and they are chipping away at this deficit. Set up and over received by Wolfenbarger, but not. Miscommunication there from the pilot side. Kind of get it together a little bit is what Haley Brown's saying. Let's take it, let's get it. Aaron Carlos gets the return. Anderson and Brown brings it home.
Big point.
Game point coming at you now.
I was starting to think that Coach Wiegand might need a timeout, but they got the point there. One point away.
Very important is game point and Wolfenbarger to serve. She's been consistent all night. The sideline is feeling it. Here she goes. Over to Cobb, receives it. Tip over, received by Anderson. Set by Carlos. Wolfenbarger, received by Cobb. And over. And that is the game, folks. Well played game all around for the Pilots.
Big win.
Big win. That is win number two at home. Pilots are now 5-6 at home. And
2-7 at home, 5-6 in the crossroads.
5-6 in the conference. Thank you, Tim. As the Foresters fall to 5-6. Yep. And now it is 2-7 at home. That is that all-important second win in the crossroads, or at home, rather. We will come at you for the next game. Bethel College takes on Davenport University on Friday, October 7th. Now, Bethel wins that last set from 25-16. But on October 7th, we'll see you back here in Goodman Gymnasium. Bethel versus Davenport, 7 p.m.